DALL-E 3 is a new tool from OpenAI that turns text into images. It's a big update from the last version, DALL-E 2, and it's much better at following complex instructions to create pictures. For example, if you tell it to make an image of a scene with specific items and how they relate to each other, it can do that very well. It can also add text to the image and make human parts like hands look more real. The great thing about DALL-E 3 is that it's very easy to use. You don't need to know any special tricks, you just type what you want, and it creates a beautiful image. DALL-E 3 works by using a big model with 12 billion parts that understand both text and images. It looks at both the words and the picture together, up to 1280 pieces at a time. It learns by trying to guess what comes next in the sequence, whether it's a word or a part of the image. This way, it gets really good at making images that match the text you give it. It's like having a very smart artist that can draw anything you can describe in words. In DALL-E 3, a token can be a part of a word, a whole word, or a part of a picture. It's different from how we usually think of tokens, like the 26 letters in the English alphabet. This tool is built directly on ChatGPT. That means you can use ChatGPT to help you think of ideas and make your instructions better. You just tell it what you want to see, from a short sentence to a big paragraph. ChatGPT then gives you a special instruction that DALL-E 3 can understand to create the picture you want. If you see a picture you like but think it needs a little change, you can tell DALL-E 3 and it will fix it for you. Right now, DALL-E 3 is in a research preview, but soon, in October, people who pay for ChatGPT Plus and businesses can use it through the API. It will also be in labs later in the fall. Like with DALL-E 2, the pictures you make are yours. You can do whatever you want with them without asking OpenAI. When you compare DALL-E 3 to other tools that turn text into pictures, it's way better. It makes pictures that look more real and have more details than the pictures from other tools. It really stands out and shows what it can do. DALL-E 3 creates images with bright colors, clear shapes, and an overall great look. On the other hand, images from Midjourney seem blurry and not very clear. Stable Diffusion XL is another popular tool that makes images from text. It claims to need fewer words and can even add text to images. However, it doesn't do as well as DALL-E 3. DALL-E 3's images are better in quality, have clearer text, and look nicer. Images from Stable Diffusion XL can look grainy and sometimes have too many small details that don't seem needed. Then there is Deep Floyd, a new tool that also claims to be good at adding text to pictures. But when compared to DALL-E 3, it's clear that Deep Floyd can't do as much. OpenAI's DALL-E 3 combines text and images in a way that looks smoother and more real. The images it creates are just better. DALL-E 3 stands out because it makes images that are easy to understand, look great, and feel just right. While other tools might not give you the same quality or might make the images too busy or unclear. So when it comes to creating images from text, DALL-E 3 is a really strong choice. DALL-E 3 is a top tool right now for changing text into images. It does a much better job than its older version, DALL-E 2, and it's also better than other available options. It creates wonderful images without needing extra help or changes. Plus, it works seamlessly with ChatGPT, making it very strong and versatile, while still being user-friendly. The ease of using an AI tool is really important, and that's one of the reasons why ChatGPT is the most popular AI chatbot around the world. While there might be other chatbots that are better for certain specific jobs, people choose ChatGPT because it's convenient and easy to use. Going back to DALL-E 3, it's the latest and greatest from OpenAI, but it's important to know about its history and how it got here. The first DALL-E came out in January 2021, and it was groundbreaking. By April 2022, the world saw DALL-E 2, which was even more advanced and changed how we think about AI-generated images. The technology behind these models, known as latent diffusion, works by gradually turning random noise into recognizable images, based on what the system has learned from its training data. This technique has also been used in other models like OpenAI's Stable Diffusion. However, OpenAI isn't the only player in the game. There are several other companies working to perfect their image-generating models. Some of these competitors have unique features and might even be better in certain specific areas. Even though DALL-E 3 is amazing, it's not without its flaws and challenges, and there are still areas that need improvement. Also, the rise of AI-generated images has sparked a lot of debate and controversy. Some people worry about the ethical implications and potential misuse of this technology. So, while DALL-E 3 is a big step forward, it's part of a bigger picture that includes ongoing innovation, competition, and discussions about responsible use. Artists around the world are worried because AI like DALL-E 3 uses a lot of art from people everywhere to learn how to make images. This has led to big concerns about copying styles in ways that aren't fair or right. There have been protests, legal actions, and even official decisions from places like the U.S. Copyright Office because of these concerns. A judge in a U.S. court also made an important decision about the copyright of art made by AI. OpenAI, the company behind DALL-E 3 and ChatGPT, is facing legal issues too. Some famous writers, including John Grisham and George R.R. Martin, say OpenAI used their work to teach ChatGPT without asking them. Because of these issues, OpenAI has put limits on DALL-E 3. It tries to stop the tool from making images that are violent, for adults only, or hateful. OpenAI also tries to prevent the creation of images of well-known people to avoid misuse, like spreading false information. And DALL-E 3 is designed to say no to requests for images in the style of an artist who is still alive, to respect their rights and creativity. However, these actions are not enough. More needs to be done to make sure DALL-E 3 is used in a way that is ethical and responsible. The issue is big, and it needs careful attention to protect artists and the public. There are many big questions and problems with AI making images. People wonder who should own the images that AI creates. They also think about how to keep art made by humans special and real. And they worry about people using AI-made images for bad things. OpenAI knows these problems are there and is working on solutions. They are making a new tool called a provenance classifier. This tool will help figure out if an image was made by DALL-E 3. OpenAI wants to use this tool to learn more about how AI-made images are used. They also want to use what they learn to make better rules and ways of doing things in the future. Now think about DALL-E 3. Do you think it's a good tool for making art? Or do you worry that it could change how we value art made by humans? Please share your thoughts in the comments. I hope this video was interesting for you. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. And think about subscribing for more videos about AI. Don't forget to ring the notification bell so you know when new videos come out. Thanks for watching and see you next time.